What the fuck?
Hello. Am talking Tara. Would you like to be my friend? I have a kitty.
Everybody.
No, you don't like my kitty?
Well, everyone is officially freaked out now. Hi, Tara. Well, interesting costume. Where the hell did you get the cat skeleton?
Spirit Halloween. The toy is miracles. And we thought that Miracle would be afraid of it, but actually Miracle just like rubbed her face along the spine and was like, "This is fucking great. It's so scratchy."
Cat's a little creepy.
Like it.
No, I mean the real one is a little creepy.
Oh. Well, she likes scritching her face on stuff.
Even though
Did I really creep everybody out?
just a bit.
Cool.
Well, Tara, it is that time of year again.
It is.
Which means, of course, we have our usual live what the fuck's wrong with you, but once we've dispensed with that, it's time for the annual Hookerween countdown. We look
Yay.
at costumes that are intended as sexy and are anything but.
Yeah. I am not Sally from A Nightmare Before Christmas. I'm talking Tara. And I don't like you anymore.
No one remembers that Twilight Zone.
No, our audience are all like 12.
Wait, why is our audience should not be 12? If you're 12, why the fuck are you watching? Where the fuck are your
Right?
parents?
Go to bed.
Mean, Jesus, where the shit are you? God damn. Do you like the thing I did?
I do. You look very Nordic.
I'm as a bearded fat guy, I have very limited costume
Oh.
choices. You know, once you've done Silent Bob once, that's it. You've kind of.
Well, it's also hard to do a 5-hour show when you can't talk.
Yeah. I semi considered doing Walter Sobchak, but that would have required either a wig or hair shaving, and I was like, nah, I'm not doing that. Not doing that. All right.
Well,
Well,
I was a Cheshire cat for the Halloween party I had this past weekend, but that's a shit ton more makeup than this and took like 2 hours to do because I had to draw the big old mouth on. Scared the shit out of poor Miracle. Poor Miracle was up drinking out of her water bowl, and I came toddling up the stairs, completely forgetting that I look like a demon cat from hell. Poor cat looks up, and this is little kitty gives no fucks, but she doesn't so much react to things. Looks up, like, leaves her mouth hanging open, water dripping out of her mouth, just like. And then she hops out of her little cubby where her food is, and her tail's all puffed up. I've never seen her tail puff up. She doesn't care about anything enough to be scared. And I was like, oh, kitty, I'm so. She wanted fuck all to do with me. She was like, nope, 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 get away. Yeah, she didn't like it so much.
See, I can't do it. I would love to be able to do the face painting kind of stuff, but you saw me in the Crow review I did. That's the best I can do. That was kind of sad.
Well, I did this semi-professionally for a while,
Well,
so
yeah, I can't do that. All
I've
right.
done makeup for 5-ish years now, so I have a lot of shit too. I have a lot of this stuff hanging around.
Well, I would like this week's what the fuck is wrong with you to be Halloween theme, but no, it's probably going to be next week. That's when we get the aftermath. Unfortunately, however, there is a different theme this week, and I'm pretty much sure that this is just cavalcade of assholes. Now, there's a difference between just normal stupidity, people do a stupid thing, and then there's willful dickery.
Yes.
And everything in this is just willful. We got a theme going here. Let's get the intro. Each week, Catherine, Radio Dead Air audience, go out in the worldwide interwebs. God, I think it's creepy. Finds all sorts of horrible things, brings it back here. Something we like to call What the Fuck Is Wrong With You? And our very first one tonight, oh, starting out of the gate, we got Vidya!
Ooh,
yeah. I'll let everybody else watch what happens here. This comes from the Denver International Airport. Let me send you on the link. And everyone else can see what happens here. Now, you see there's a plane pulling away from the gate. Everyone can watch. But if you watch, there he is. Out on the tarmac, that's Mark Ramar. Video released Tuesday shows a man running onto the tarmac trying to stop the flight he missed.
Yeah, that's not going to work.
Prosecutors say Mark Ramar pushed open a secure emergency exit door on a concourse. God damn it, screen. Tonight, really, you're going to do this? On a concourse at a Denver International Airport. Door triggered an alarm, and airport employees and Denver police responded. Ramar was arrested.
Yeah, that only works in romantic comedies.
Does it even work then, though?
Kind of like how stalking people and fucking up their employment only works to get you laid in romantic comedies. That doesn't work in real life.
Yeah. Yeah, don't do that. Don't. You're not getting on that plane.
No.
That's not.
You might not be getting on any plane for a while because now you're on a list.
Yes. They don't. It's not like a secret. It's not like a cheat code. It's not like you found the special level with that door that says do not open. That means everybody. That means you too.
Yes. That does, in fact, mean you too. You are not special. The rules of the world apply to you just like everybody else. I know it's sad. I know it's hard to believe because you are. I mean, you're you. You're special.
Your mom told you so.
I can't tell you how many times when I worked at Sephora at Christmas, we'd have people come in at like 2 o'clock on a Saturday and be like, do I really have to stand in that line? No, you? You know, we didn't know you were coming. Hang on, let us roll out the special register. Yeah, because you came shopping at 2 o'clock on a Saturday in fucking December. Yeah, you have to stand in that line because you're not fucking special.
And what elevates this to being true assholery is the fact that because he did this, the plane has to stop, security has to come out, everybody runs around like chickens with their heads cut off, and hey, every single person on that plane isn't going nowhere.
Yep, they're all missing their connecting flights. And you're still not getting on the plane.
You're still not getting on the fucking plane! I know it sucks. I've missed flights. I've had flights missed on me. Dealing with it sucks, but there is no circumventing unless you're really rich. Then you have your own plane.
Right.
You don't just get to... you run out of the...
And you should be glad that you're not going to make it on that plane, because if you did, everybody on it would kick the shit out of you.
Yes. They should be legally allowed to do that, you know?
Yeah.
If you interfere with a plane attempting to leave, everyone who you've inconvenienced should get, like, you know, two hits. Everyone on the plane get a good two. That should be law. We should, you know, we used to have the stocks. We used to have public humiliation.
Humiliation needs to come back. Public shaming.
It does.
I really think is a thing we need to get back into.
Speaking of shame and the lack thereof, we have more airplane shenanigans. This time from Ireland.
Yeah, I saw this.
Yeah, you knew this was fucking coming.
Did not expect the zombie apocalypse to start in Ireland.
Drunk Irishman makes emergency landing after plane makes emergency landing after drunk naked man demanded sex with flight attendant.
Oh no, this isn't the one I was thinking of.
Isn't the one you were thinking of? Oh no, this is different.
Because there was one where a guy on an Aer Lingus flight went crazy, bit another passenger, and then died.
Yeah, we don't do those. That's not funny. That's messed up. This, however, is different. Pilot was forced to make an emergency landing after a drunk Irishman reportedly took off his clothes, swung his penis around.
Did he do the helicopter dick?
Don't applaud him! Don't applaud him! And even demanding sex with a flight attendant.
Always applaud the helicopter dick.
A Sun Express flight from Dublin to Turkey was forced to land in Belgrade, Serbia. Wow, that would suck. Forced landing in Belgrade, Serbia. Due to altercation between the man and the flight staff, fellow passengers reported the man's friends cheered him throughout the incident. So this was an asshole with a douchebag chorus.
Yeah.
He insulted the crew, resisted security guards, even tried to physically attack our officers. He was quickly overcome and detained until he sobered up.
Don't get naked in the airport or on the plane.
Oh,
unless you've done something to make the TSA force you to do so, don't do it.
It gets better. While waiting at Nikola Tesla Airport in Serbian capital, witnesses said the Irishman's friends, allegedly wearing beach clothes, proceeded to drink 250 pints between them, allegedly delaying the flight 10 hours. Spokesman told the Mail Online, there was a girl who was so drunk, she was offering sex to airport employees. The girl even offered sex to police officers at the scene who were trying to calm the situation down.
How many people were in this group? That's a lot of beer.
Jesus Christ. It was like an asshole convention broke out.
Yeah. And then they got fucked up.
Just
don't go whipping it out in public. Don't get naked on the plane. Don't. I don't even really understand people who want to have sex on airplanes. One, because I'm terrified of flying. But two, because every surface on an airplane has been touched and rubbed upon by so many thousands of people before you, and the air is recycled. That's just asking for an alien infection of some kind.
It's like fucking in a petri dish.
Yeah. That's asking for infections they haven't even discovered yet.
But 250 points, delaying a flight for 10 hours because you couldn't just not drink for a bit.
Yeah.
Assholes! It's not a sky party. Other people have to go places.
Or if you want a sky party, get your own damn plane.
Rent your own fucking plane.
Get yourself a fucking charter flight. And Tony Stark that shit up.
Yeah, then you can whip your dick out as much as you like with your buddies in the sky, and no one else has to deal with your drunk ass.
Exactly.
I guess our next one is a little Halloween-y. Did you ever have, like, someone in the neighborhood that all the kids used to say was, like, a witch or that scary old man that was going to murder you or something?
No, actually.
Really?
No.
We had like this old couple. I'm sure they were perfectly sweet old people, but they didn't come out much, and their house, the front was a little overgrown, and we always only saw them occasionally. So we were like jackass little kids, and we thought they were like, you know, going to eat us or something.
Like the neighbor from Home Alone.
Right. Except in this case, I think the reputation would be a little warranted. Champlin woman charged with threatening neighbor's children. Minneapolis. A 38-year-old Champlin woman has been charged with allegedly sending anonymous threats to neighbors regarding their children. On Friday, Carrie Pernula was charged via summon with one gross misdemeanor count of stalking and one misdemeanor count of disorderly conduct in connection with the series of events that began on September 27th. According to police, Pernula sent the anonymous threats to her neighbors because she was upset that the children had made noise and left items in her yard. The first anonymous threat arrived September 27th by mail. The two short sentences said, "The children look delicious. May I have a taste?"
No, no, you may not.
Then the family began receiving magazine subscriptions. Instead of a name on the address label, it said things like "Tasty Children" along those lines.
What magazine mails out a magazine to that address? Like, how does the fucking data entry intern at that magazine not be like, shenanigans? Guys, I don't think this is right. Like, maybe Tasty is someone's last name and it is for their children, but I feel like we should check.
That is fucking psychotic.
And why don't the slightly overcooked children get a magazine? That's not fair. It's not their fault that they've gone off by a couple of days. They should get a magazine too.
I'm just imagining the dad. He's like, yeah, honey, I understand. It's a little upsetting. But on the plus side, Free Sports Illustrated. So, yeah. You know, no. The kids, sure, the kids. But it is the swimsuit issue. the kids. Sure, the kids. That is going above and fuck. She spent money to order a magazine subscription just to fucking creep out.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. And here's the thing, guys. Here's the thing about harassing people through the mail. They can track it. They know where the mail comes from.
And they don't like it when you fuck with people via the mail. They get cranky about that.
That's actually a federal offense.
They get cranky about that
shit.
You
have fucked with an agency of the federal government. Post office doesn't fuck around, actually.
They are overworked, underappreciated, and no time for your shit.
Yeah, they don't fuck around.
I barely shell out money for shit I like. I would not be shelling out money for people I hate.
Yeah, to send them magazines. Like, if you're gonna send something to somebody you hate, make it like the roadkill you found on the side of the street.
That's free. That doesn't cost anything.
Or a box of glitter.
Yeah, that's insidious shit. There.
Like, don't make it something they're gonna enjoy.
Yeah, it's like
you're gonna torment someone through the mail. Be smart. Make it awful.
Be a little frugal with your terror, you know?
Don't send them, like, a book of awesome coupons.
This is like reverse Martha Stewart or something.
Or at least send them subscriptions to horrible magazines, like Serial Killers Monthly and Forbes.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, if someone sent me Forbes in the mail, I'd be like,
what have I done to you?
Well, I guess our next one is a little creepy, too, because no one really likes clowns. No one does. Anyone who says they do is they're kind of lying. And everyone has always been a little creeped out by Ronald McDonald. So I can kind of understand where this next story is coming from. But they took it a little too far. Ronald McDonald's statue burned, decapitated, has feet cut off. Vandals have burned, decapitated, and cut the feet off a smiling Ronald McDonald statue that sat outside a Ronald McDonald house in Vermont. The statue occupied a bench outside the Burlington home for years, welcoming sick children and families who need to be close to the University of Vermont's Children's Hospital. The volunteers moved the statue's main to storage because children were traumatized by seeing it. Look at this. And look, there's Ronald's head and his feet.
Why his feet?
Why would you cut him? He's not getting up.
Did you think he was going to chase you?
No. Don't just get the head. You got to get the feet too, or he'll come after us.
Is that like a ritualistic thing? Are they really, really devoted to Burger King? Did they fucking sacrifice him to the Burger King?
I just... That is just... What are... Kids have got to see that. All right, yeah, maybe Ronald McDonald is already a little creepy, but headless Ronald McDonald is 10 times.
Okay, Mike says you cut off his feet so his ghost can't chase you. Here's the thing, it's a statue of a fictional character. I don't think the ghost of the statue of Ronald McDonald is coming for you.
It's not the crow. It's not the fucking crow.
And this is fucking me. I believe in everything. I'm mad at Dan because he wants to do the elevator game. I watched that weird video going around the internet last week of the guy in the plague mask, and I couldn't fucking sleep. Like, everything freaks me out. And I'm here to tell you...
Tell him about the Halloween party.
Yeah, we had a Halloween party, and one of my friends came dressed as the guy from that creepy video on the plague mask. Have you seen this video?
No, and I don't think I want to.
It's horrible. Like, it's just a dude in a plague mask and a big thing, and he's doing, like, hand symbols, and there's all kinds of shit. And when they run the stereogram, the thing where they turn the sound into pictures, it says, like, you are already dead, and there's all kind of codes, and there's, like, the coordinates for the White House and all these pictures of tortured women that turned out to be stills from horror movies. And Reddit has been going nuts trying to decode this whole thing. And it's really fucked up and really scary. And one of my friends came to my Halloween party dressed as that dude, and I was like, no, you can't come in. No, go home. You cannot come in. So from the chick who's afraid of fucking everything, pretty sure the ghost of the Ronald McDonald statue is not coming to get you. Just saying.
This is where sick kids go. Sick kids.
Yeah.
When their families can't afford to stay with them. Or when, you know, this is... charity, and you're fucking
up. This is one of the few things McDonald's really, really does right.
Yeah. God knows it isn't hamburgers.
No, they're kind of my guilty pleasure, but I know it's like there's nothing in there that's actual food. Just, you guys don't know about this video?
No, I don't think I wanna.
It was mailed on a DVD to a tech blog in Sweden, I think. Nobody knows who made it. Reddit has figured out that it was filmed in an abandoned mental hospital in Poland, but people don't know. Like, theories are it's viral marketing for the next Dan Brown movie, that it's some kind of fucking apocalyptic cult planning to release a plague on everybody, that it's, you know, internet trolls, but it's really elaborate and really creepy and stuff. And it has just layers and layers of shit embedded in the video and the sound, whatever. And
I don't want to know. I'd be happier, you know, without knowing these things. I didn't need to know.
Because I feel like it's kind of like the video from The Ring. Like, I watched it and I was like, oh my God, I have to wait, make someone else watch it, or now I'm going to die.
That someone else is not me.
Sorry.
Well, moving right along to more dickery. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. You know the old phrase, when you gotta go, you gotta go?
Yes.
I never once saw the inclusion of a machete to that equation. Seattle. Seattle's infamously slow traffic finally worked to society's advantage Thursday when a machete-wielding man got caught in a traffic jam while trying to evade police. Officers were called to Capitol Hill's Cal Anderson Park on Thursday after getting reports a belligerent man was threatening people with a machete and a throwing knife. Witnesses told officer the man was using the woman's restroom. When he was confronted, he pulled out a 2-foot-long machete, swung it around, and threatened to kill a half dozen people. The man then armed himself with a throwing knife and acted as if he was going to hurl it at his victims. Police on their way, the man decided to make a getaway. He got into a car parked next to the park and tried to speed away, but he didn't account for rush hour traffic. Police soon caught up with and arrested the man. When asked why he had the weapons, the suspect said he had them because he is a, quote, trained fucking killer, according to police.
Okay.
When officers asked why he was using the woman's bathroom at the park, he allegedly said the men's room was full and he had a, quote, explosive bowel issue.
Man, there's just nothing worse than a trained fucking killer with an explosive bowel issue.
Okay.
Like Friday the 13th 4, right? Like when Jason just got really bad diarrhea.
Black Raptor just won the chat. Well, he lost his shit.
Something happened there and I didn't hear.
I said Black Raptor just won the chat. Well, he lost his shit.
Yeah. Like, I know you're mad that you paid money for Taco Bell and all that, but don't go taking it out on the unsuspecting public. It's your fault you went to Taco Bell.
Look, you couldn't. All right. Look, I'm not even going to get into the politics of gender and bathrooms and whatnot. Fine. First off, you couldn't wait just a few seconds for one dude to get out of the bathroom. Two, even if you couldn't wait and people called you on it and just, why the machete? Why the throwing knife? Why did you have to threaten to end people's lives because they had a problem with you pooping in the women's bathroom?
Because a chalupa, man.
No! No, I don't understand. I don't understand.
Now I want Taco Bell.
I don't understand.
Is that the cat?
What did the cat do?
I just heard this grumbling noise from all the way across the room.
The cat didn't like that joke.
She doesn't want Taco Bell. No care of Taco Bell for the cat. Maybe this cat would like Taco Bell.
Why do you go to the bathroom with a machete? Who takes a machete to the bathroom?
If you're in zombie land?
We're not! It's Seattle! Maybe if it was Portland, I could understand. Because, you know, if you're in a bathroom in Portland, things can get a little weird. I can understand having... But it's Seattle! Come the fuck on! Just fucking hell. Danny Trejo, Duquette says, well, maybe Danny Trejo takes a machete into the bathroom, but he's polite enough not to use it on anyone.
Yeah.
Because he's got class. Danny Trejo's got class.
He just leaves it on the changing table.
Finally tonight. Oh, God. Ladies and gentlemen. There have been many an asshole in our time that you've encountered that we've presented to you on this show. Many an asshole whose behavior has just been completely un-fucking acceptable. But I promise you, this next asshole, he is going for the gold. This is... Did you ever see Star Wars Return of the Jedi? Do you remember the Sarlacc pit? That great big hole in the desert they tried to
push? Yeah, that was the big anus in the middle of the desert that ate Boba Fett, right?
This guy is challenging.
That's what it looks like.
This guy is challenging that title for largest anus.
See? He said that's what it looks like, too.
And we have a bit of video here. Let's watch. Man dances on ex's roof after setting her house on fire.
Well, that's just dumb. Once you set the house on fire, get the fuck out of there. You're going to die.
Indianapolis, police said a man stole his ex-girlfriend's car, drove it into a utility pole, set fire to her home, and then climbed on the roof and danced during a standoff. Police said they found 25-year-old Matthew Russ sitting in a chair in his ex-girlfriend's driveway holding a butcher knife. Police shot at him with rubber bullets and Russ retreated back in the home. Short time later, smoke was seen coming from the house and Russ emerged on the roof. Police department's crisis negotiators tried to coax him from a second-story perch. Even when flames broke through the rooftop, Russ ignored the danger in front and behind him. Fearing they'd run out of time, police again shot Russ with rubber bullets and a stun gun. They used a ladder to retrieve the incapacitated man from the roof and lowered him to the ground. Victim was unharmed. No police officers or firefighters were hurt.
Like, I've had some bad breakups.
Yeah, ditto. But...
like, I've wanted to burn a motherfucker's house down a time or two, I'm not gonna lie. I don't think I would stay there and dance among the flames.
I love how you're focusing back on the wrong aspect of all this.
That's just bad survivalism. You set the fire, you leave the place where the fire is.
And look at this happy, dancing asshole motherfucker. I'm gonna play it again. Just there he is, getting down. Oh yeah.
Goddamn yeah! Set your house on fire. But you're also going to die. Yeah.
You mother man. However angry you get at your ex.
Yeah, I would like to play. I wanted to set a motherfucker's house on fire. I've never done it because that would be wrong.
No, you would go to jail.
Yes.
Difference.
Well, also it would be wrong.
I've been so angry at exes before. But you know, you gotta let shit go. You gotta just cut that shit away. Move the fuck on and let it go. Don't steal the fucking car, set the house on fire. What is your end game here? Oh my God, you stole my car. I love you.
No, at that point, it's not getting them back. At that point, it's ruining them.
Well...
I know some people who have done not things to this level, but not far off. I'm not going to name names. And it wasn't about getting them back. It was about fucking them up irreparably. It's a whole different ballgame.
Except, you know, criminal record. Jail.
Yeah. And possibly horrible burning death.
Yeah. And, you know, the lawsuits. You're never getting out of debt the rest of your life. You'll have liens on all your shit. Even if you don't pay, you're fucked. There's no upside here. You have fucked yourself. You are quite fucked. There is no unfucking. Once fucked, never unfucked. You have fucked yourself. And not in a fun way.
But by golly, you got to dance.
This guy pisses me off so much. Because, you know, whatever your ex has done, let it go.
They might have pets.
Well, that's still fucking creepy as shit with the dead cat. Just let it go. Get on. Oh, for fuck's sake. Get on with your life. Try to pick yourself up. And if just never deal with them again, ever. You'll be much fucking happier.
Yeah, that's true.
And also not in jail.
Also true.
That's I guess that's the first thing we learned this week. Is, first off, fucking move on. Don't go to jail. Simple, easy. Also, Tara would burn your house down if she can get away with it.
Only if you cross me.
Like I said, Tara would burn it.
I'm talking Tara, and you better be nice to me.
We've learned that you probably, there is no need.
Unless, I have to go over here.
Unless you're expecting anacondas in the bathroom, there is no need to take a machete with you. You know,
there are some places, like if you're in Australia, by all means, take a machete to the bathroom with you.
If you're in Seattle, I think you're okay.
Yeah.
We've learned you don't have to cut the feet off the Ronald McDonald statue after you vandalized it. Its ghost will not chase you.
Yeah, he's not coming for you.
We've learned if you're going to be horrible to your neighbor's children, don't pay money for it. I don't think we're learning good lessons. We're not learning good lessons.
Well, we're not learning morally good lessons. We are learning important lessons.
We've learned if you're going to get fucked up on a flight, charter your own. Don't subject everyone else to your helicopter dick.
Yeah.
Helicopter dick is a command performance, okay?
True.
It's one of those that you have to request specially. It's not one that's for the general public.
Yeah.
Okay. And finally, we've learned that if you delay a fucking flight, you ass need to get beat. Also, you are not special. Door, that keep out includes you.
You are not a special fucking snowflake.
Rick.
Well, I guess you're special now in that everybody hates you. So.
Donald Trump has that covered.